Hello friends. When I was asked, where do you see yourself in 5 years? What did I say was, I see myself as your boss. Or if not the boss, at least sitting next to you, taking interviews of other students. Obviously, I got rejected. And this is what I don't want you to do or repeat. That is why I'm bringing you how to answer why this question is important and what should you do, what you should not do. Let's get started. So friend, let me talk about why do I feel this question is useless. First reason is, this question is hypothetical. This question is not on a real premises because they are asking you something what will happen 5 years down the line. Second reason, there is no right or wrong answer to this question because this is not based on a real premises, or this is something which can be judged, which can be evaluated on your answers. Third is, there cannot be a follow-up question. Reason why I'm saying so, because if you say something or the other thing, a good answer or a bad answer, they cannot ask you why not or why so. All right friends, let's talk about why this question is very important. First thing is, based on this question, the interviewer can judge the excitement which you have. If you sound very low, they know that this guy is not excited for the role. Second, they can judge your knowledge based on your answer. They can judge your knowledge of the role which you are going to fill in for the job. Third, they can judge your plan, your vision about the role, how you want to pursue your journey, how you want to go ahead and play this role. Fourth, they can see the honesty in your answer and also the practicality. And it's clearly visible how you project yourself in 5 years. Second last, they can count on your sincerity. If you are sincere or non-sincere, this question can clearly divide your answers. Last is, they can count on your commitment. It's very important whenever you answer this question, you have to show that how committed you are for the job which they are offering. So how to answer this question? What you should put in your answer so that it becomes a complete, honest and best answer. I have broken down this question into 3 key aspects. Whenever an interviewer asks this question, they are looking for these 3 ingredients in your answer. The very first one is attitude and honesty. When I'm saying attitude, as I mentioned, how excited and how joyful you are to grab this role. That is one thing which they are looking for. At the same time, along with your attitude, they're looking for the honesty. Are you showing a fake excitement? So attitude plus honesty, that is something which makes the answer complete. Second, skills and ambitions. When you're giving this answer, are you talking about improving and banging on your skills? At the same time, ambitions and the true ambition. I'm not saying that I want to become CEO of the company in 5 years. For that, this is a good ambition, but at the same time, is it practical? Is it very much near to the actual situations based on your skills? So ambitions supported by your skills. Are you giving that answer, yes or no? Third is thoughtfulness. When you're answering, how thoughtful for preparing this answer. If you are saying that you want to become a CEO and that too in a company like Google or Deloitte, that means you are not thoughtful. Based on your skills, your credentials, you need to think how thoughtful you are with your answers. So if you have put in all these 3 ingredients in your answer, I can assure you that your answer is perfect. All right friends, this is about how do you give the answer. There are few things which you should avoid while giving this answer. So I have listed down these 7 points which you should always avoid while giving answer to this question. The very first thing is, you should not just tell a role that I want to become an editorial manager, I want to become a senior manager without a plan. So when you are giving answer to this question, you should be giving just not a role but also the plan of it. Second is, don't jump straight to 5 years. As I said, when you're saying a role, you're also talking about a plan, a journey. You should break down your answer into phrases saying, in first 2 years, I want to do this. I want to grow this particular skill based on which I'll be in next 3 years, I'll be accomplishing this particular role. Third, don't try to be funny. As I mentioned in my answer earlier that I said, I want to be your boss or I want to be sitting next to you. This is not funny. They're not looking for a humorous person. Right? So try to be as sincere as possible. Avoid going without a plan. When you say something, always back it up with a plan. Next is, never ever say some specific roles which are very impossible to achieve, like CEO of the company or global head of the company. And commonly I have seen people saying, I don't know where I would be. I don't know what I will be doing next day or next year. How can I answer this question about 5 years? This is also not the right answer. The reason why I'm saying so, every company needs a person who has a vision, who has a roadmap of his own success. And that is your chance to show that how much thoughtful you are about your own success. All right, friend. The last point, what you should avoid telling is about your future plans and switching the companies or going for higher studies. This is not something which is showing your true commitment for the company. So avoid telling them that you will be part of some ABCD company or you will be part of some ABCD defense services or you will go and join some higher studies in some state or some college. Never ever say that. That shows that you are not committed towards the company, and that actually disqualifies you compared to other 50 people sitting next to you for the same role. So avoid answering these kind of answers. All right, friends. This brings me to the last topic of our discussion today. Tips, do's and don'ts. Please read them very carefully. These are based on my own 12 years of experience where I have given more than 40 plus interviews and I have taken more than 100 interviews so far. And I can assure you that I myself don't like to hear such answers where people are trying to show off, they are trying to be extraordinarily ambitious, they are not coming with a plan, or they are trying to be funny with me. So please make sure that you follow these do's, don'ts, and also the tips which I've given. This can help you to prepare a very good script based on the role. Either you are a fresher or you are a person with an experience. All right, friends, leave your comments below. Ask me any question which you have related to interview. Or if you are interested to do a one-on-one session in terms of interviews, I can conduct those also. I have some plans down the line where I'll be conducting one-on-one session with you based on how urgent it is for you. So drop your comments. Let me know if you are interested to do some mock interviews.